GeneratorPowerSource.com here for a real world runtime test of the Westinghouse WGEN3600. This is a dual fuel generator. We are going to be running on gasoline first, and then we also will test propane in the future. We are actually living in our travel trailer right now. This is a Grand Design Imagine 2670 MK, 26 and a half feet, 31 overall. We have a 15,000 BTU air conditioner that we will be running. We also have an electric fireplace that pulls about 12 and a half amps. If you want to know what every item in your travel trailer pulls, we have past videos on that. We want to just see how long does the generator last on a full tank of gas, living as if we would live. So we're going to go ahead and fuel up the Westinghouse WGEN3600 to capacity, and we'll fire it up and we will be underway. And then we will take you on the inside of the travel trailer and show you exactly what we're running on a day-to-day basis, so you have an idea if it's comparable to what you run, and then you'll have an idea of the total runtime. So let's go ahead and fire this up and then take you inside. All right, guys, so we're just gonna show you real quick what we have been running while we're running the Westinghouse WGEN3600. First thing I wanna point out is our electric hot water heater. We have that on, of course. That's gonna cycle on and off throughout the day based on need, but it is on, and you will definitely hear the generator rev up when that thing is cycling. Next up is the TV. We usually have the TV running throughout the day, whether it's the news in the morning or something on in the afternoon. For the last couple of mornings, and especially this morning, we ran our electric fireplace for about 2 hours. So it's quite cool when you wake up in the morning. We don't kick on our furnace. We usually just come on out here and turn on our electric fireplace. This is pulling about 12 amps, just so you know. And we also simultaneously in the morning will be running our heated seats on our recliners. The heated seats in the recliners doesn't draw much, but we do run it in the morning so you get an idea of what we're running. We always have our laptops on back here, and yes, I do carry an external monitor, but when these are running, I'm only pulling like 2 amps, so it's not a huge draw, but these things are on all day, as well as the refrigerator. And again, the refrigerator is going to be much like the electric hot water heater. It's cycling on and off based on need, but we do have that plugged on AC. Every morning we come out and we'll warm up our coffee. It's only a couple minutes between the two of us, but the microwave is pulling about 12 and a half amps. So it is a heavy draw, but it's only brief. The AC is drawing about 14 and a half amps, and usually we only kick that on for about an hour a day when in the peak of the afternoon when we're inside working at the laptops. It can get pretty hot. This is a 15,000 BTU air conditioner, so it's pulling about 14 amps because it's still quite cool outside. I think in the peak of summer we might get up to 18 amps, but like I said, we're only running that for about an hour a day just to cool down the inside. So that's a look around of what we are running on a day-to-day basis. That's what we're running throughout this test, so you can kind of gauge for yourself. Maybe you're in a 38-foot fifth wheel, which is way bigger than this, and you might have dual ACs pulling way more power. Or maybe you're just in a 16-foot pop-up camper and you only need a suitcase generator. So I just want to give you an idea so you can make comparisons of what our travel trailer looks like compared to what you have or what you're considering, and you can make a decision on, okay, I have more needs or I have less needs, and we'll check back in once the Westinghouse WGEN3600 runs out of fuel.
Well, I didn't think we were ever gonna make it to the end of this video, but we finally have. Westinghouse advertises 18 hours runtime with a quarter load on the WGEN3600 dual fuel. And I thought that was a little bit of a stretch, but we proved it to be almost true. We went 17 hours of runtime, and we ran it pretty heavily. I mean, we were living in our travel trailer. We ran the electric fireplace for a couple hours in the morning. We kicked on the AC for an hour in the afternoon. So we used it like we would be living in it, and we went 17 hours. I don't know if we want to say that's a quarter load or not, but we seem to be averaging about 4.5 amps when one of the heavy appliances is not engaged, like the AC, the microwave, or the hot water heater. But we did have the hot water heater running the whole time that we tested this, and again, 17 hours. So really impressive for the Westinghouse WGEN3600 dual fuel. I will say it is a little bit bit louder for us in the travel trailer, especially in the morning when I get up a little bit earlier and crank on that electric fireplace. It is a little bit louder in the bedroom compared to some of the inverter generators, but we just wanted to give you an idea of what kind of runtime you can expect out of this generator. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe, give us a thumbs up. It's what helps us to keep going. GeneratorPowerSource.com with a real world runtime test of the Westinghouse WGEN3600 dual fuel.